Greetings, humans. I'm Andre, and I'm George, and welcome back to the Windmill Full of Corpses. Now we're checking out a suggestion from me. So we're taking a break from the suggestion train to check out a new song that's come out just 2 days ago, and I guess fill me in. Yeah, so this is False Memories, Rain of Souls. It's an Italian symphonic metal band, I would say groove-infused symphonic metal. I heard the previous song. By groove-infused, I expect you mean it's groovy, not that it has groove metal stuff.
No, it doesn't have groove metal stuff, because groove metal stuff are like...
Yeah, groove metal stuff implies camo pants and stinky dudes.
Yeah, and that's definitely not going on here.
Okay, so this is the second single from their upcoming album. I don't remember the title of the album. The album's coming out sometime in May. This is the second single. First one was Voices. That's the only song I heard. And their guitarist added me on Facebook. So I decided, and I don't know, I exchanged some comments with him and he seemed nice, and I just thought,
why the hell reaction
to his band? So this is called Rain of Souls.
Yes.
That sounds like something that would be a level 10 ability for some avatar in some game.
Let's hope it's a level 10 song.
Let's see. I have thoughts. I like this. This is pretty jammy.
Give me your thoughts.
I like the mixing on the guitars and the bass. It sounds a little bit industrial, I would say. This isn't sounding very symphonic to me, to be honest. I think
the previous song was a bit more symphonic, or maybe they're just tagged symphonic.
I don't know, but admittedly, I think it's more like a groovy melodic metal song at this point.
Yeah, one thing I really noticed that is cool is that the drummer has got that weird
jazzy grip again.
Jazzy grip, yeah. When have we seen that before?
I don't even remember. We've seen that in another video before.
I think in Airborne Toxicity.
Oh, I think so, yeah. So that was the only non-metal thing we did, so checks out. And yeah, that was a cool thing to see. And I never would have guessed these guys are Italian if I would have seen them without knowing they're Italian. They look like they're from another planet.
Yeah, it's like it's from the Matrix. I like the whole scenery they got
this
going
is,
on there.
This is how you should make videos in COVID, because this is definitely green screen and with everything behind them. Sort of feel.
Yeah, I actually know it was green screen because I saw some pictures on social media about how they recorded it, and it was green screen.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I like this song.
Yeah.
Okay, so what I want to say at this point is I like that the song started are pretty chill, but it just seems to be picking up as it goes, gradually, yeah, bit by bit. At this point, it's at least instrumentally, it's pretty intense, it's pretty heavy, and it's got some cool dynamics. Something I really like that they're doing, I think, especially on the choruses, they have like just this chord kind of going, like you would on a regular chorus where the vocals are singing and there's just chords on the background, and then they'll just cut it and do some runs,
mm-hmm.
and then land back into that.
Yeah, that's a cool detail.
That's really cool, and they got a lot of this like sliced stuff going on the riffs and
mm-hmm.
on the drums. So, really interesting composition style. It's, I don't think I've heard a lot of stuff that would sound like this.
Especially if we're thinking symphonic metal bands from Italy, because Italy's like your place to go for that. One thing I notice with symphonic bands a lot is that they have like a heavy orchestral component, and this is sounding really kind of stripped down, and
yeah,
so it's different.
1 minute left, listen. Frontiers. The Last Night of Fall, that's it.
We know
that,
Seven
yeah.
Spires from Frontiers, and Seven Spires is the best band on Frontiers.
And Novena.
Seven Spires is the best band on Frontiers.
Seven Spires is the best band on Frontiers. Check out Seven Spires. Anyway, back to False Memories. How'd you dig it?
There weren't any souls ringing, but it's not what I expected. I expected like heavy orchestrals, and I guess it sounded kind of dark and ominous,
and also if you look at the video, like the imagery is like a bit post-apocalyptic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and everything about it sounded raw. Even the vocals, there wasn't a lot of processing on the vocals. There weren't like high soaring soprano dropping operatics or anything like that. So it's just not what you'd expect when you hear Italian symphonic metal, and I don't know anything about this band, so I don't know actually what they're tagged. So
yeah,
I mean
that's what I saw them tagged as, was like symphonic metal. Personally, I place more like groovy melodic metal, I guess,
with some industrial hints
yeah.
on the mix. That's what I got. Like they don't have any Rammstein keyboard cheesy stuff, but they do have kind of that.
But there is some cinematic component in there.
Yeah, and it has this sort of post-apocalyptic dystopian aesthetic that fits often with like industrial stuff. So
yeah, now about the vocals,
mm-hmm.
I really like her vocals. It's really melodic. It's got this. It doesn't happen a lot that I think like a singer just has this kind of like silky soothing texture
mm-hmm.
to her voice. So that's pretty cool. What I didn't really like was that I think it was coming forward a bit too much in the mix on the like less heavy, on the like softer sides.
I did think something along the lines of that, like way back when I was hearing bands with like raw sounding vocals like this, but I think what's the problem with it is, well, the problem with it, it's not bad or anything, it's just that it's, you need like a little bit of layering and processing, I think, for
to have it more full, to
yeah.
sound more...
Yeah. But everything about this sounded stripped down. So it's not my go-to as a preference.
Yeah, I think you'd actually have to listen to it a few more times to actually get into it. Anyway, and the last thing I want to comment on is like their look. Like the bassist with a black stripe over his head and her like superhero or supervillain outfit and everything fits very well with the... imagery.
Mm-hmm.
And also, what was the punchline at the end? Because I didn't follow the narrative of the video. Did you follow the narrative?
No, but there were these guys with the masks and the little screen on top of them the entire time, and they were the guys in the band, I think.
Yeah, and I think like whoever was that they were looking at, that dying person or
mm-hmm.
whatever in there with like the face paint, I think that was her, And then the bad guys turned out to be the band. So that was a cool touch at the end.
Yeah, but this is something that you see quite often in videos with the narrative, that you don't really know who's doing the narrative and then it turns out to be the band. I think I've seen that
cool.
a couple of times before. So anyway, thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed this video, we greatly appreciate the likes and shares. Don't forget to drop your suggestions in the comments. And if you want to see more of us, don't forget to subscribe with bells on.
Thank you very much for stopping by. We hope you enjoyed your stay, and we'd love to see you back at the windmill very soon.
Corpses out.